Hi everyone. Welcome to Heather's Art Adventures. I hope you're ready to have some fun. Hello and welcome to Heather's Art Adventure. I actually remembered to unmute myself before I started this time. I'm so proud. I know it's like you guys would not even notice that, but I sit here fumbling and I've already said everything I wanted to say and then, oh, unmute. All right. And we've got Jules in the house with us. Thank you, Jules, for being here.
Good morning, everyone.
And it looks like we have Jane and Andy out there too. So glad you guys are there.
Yeah.
I need to remove the box. All right. So we are working on this piece. It's probably going to be our last day, probably. I'm thinking we can finish it. We'll see. Looks like Nikki made it. Good morning.
Morning, Nikki.
Love it.
Looking good, Heather. Looking really good.
We'll see. I mean, I'm liking it. I'm liking it. That's
Good.
usually a new thing, so. All right, let me change my. I just have to turn off my personal thing here. Let's see, where did it go? I need to title that face so I can see it easier. Thank you, Nikki. That's awesome of you to say. Okay, so we've been just working on these details here in the front section and those shadows. I'm loving that. I think the shadows made a huge difference.
It
It's
did.
funny. It's funny how mentally it put in shadows back here too now. Like there's no shadow there. I did not put a shadow here, but it sort of looks like it on screen, doesn't
It does, yeah.
it?
I thought you'd been
So,
doing a bit more to
no, I promise. I promise. Oh, shoot. Knock over the whole table. That's great, Heather. Okay. All right, let's see. Oh, I just realized that our tip jar is missing. Why is our tip jar missing?
Maybe it's because you came on screen, I don't know.
I don't know either. Well, that's incredibly disappointing. All right, I see Melissa has arrived. Hello, Melissa. You
Oh,
know,
good morning.
I really need to check something, you guys. I'm going to do a test here because if my little thingies don't work, I'm gonna cry like a baby.
Gonna check that they're
Yeah.
working. Yeah.
Yeah. Do you guys mind if I just take a minute here to check this? Because it has made me so happy to have the little jingle thingies going on. So this is a test. Nobody's actually doing this. We're gonna do a test right now. And you guys don't hear anything, and we don't see anything. So our test is gone.
Oh dear.
Sadness. What has happened to the test? Let me
No
see.
idea.
My settings aren't wrong. So let me just copy this and put it back. So I'm going to do a black screen for just a second. I'm not gone.
Okay.
I'm not gone. I'm still here. I promise I'm still here. That's why I'm talking, so that way, as you guys know, I'm still here. Paste that in there. And these are on. This is on. Okay, one more check. One more check. The jar. We need the jar. We're gonna copy that.
Especially now, Mr. Crafter knows that he's on the little jibs.
It's absolutely necessary. I
Yeah.
mean, don't you think? Yeah, I'm still here, guys. I'm still here. Just testing, just fixing these things here. Save that. All right, now let's do a test. Whoops, I got to go back to the other screen. This is terrible. This is terrible to do all this live. Oh my gosh. It's still not working.
Oh.
All right. Well, we have no happinesses.
It's not good.
What in the world took place that removed all of these things? That's so strange. Everything's gone. All right. Well, don't nobody give me no bits or follow or sub today, because we'll miss the jingle jangles if you do.
Yeah.
All right. All right, let's go ahead and get started with this thing, because I want to get it done. I'm loving this. I want to frame it, put it up for sale on our new store, which is live, by the way. We are officially going to be announcing it in the next coming days. So please, please, please.
Well done.
Yeah. Oh, thank you very much. Your check's in the mail for sure.
Jen's here and she's saying maybe Michael can help.
Yeah, maybe he can. He needs to come over and fix it for me.
Yeah.
All right, let's see here. I'm just trying to get my colors out.
Nikki says there's no crying in arting.
Exactly right.
Yeah.
Exactly right. No crying in arting. All right, and just need a couple browns, and they're on a different layer of pencil, of course, and I don't have enough room sitting up in this high chair to find where all of these are going to go. Let's see. Okay, here we go. Now I'm set. Ooh, and now I almost spilled all my pencils. So we're using polychromos today to finish this piece up, as well as when I find it necessary, our SoCal, they're not called SoCal, SoHo soft pencil, soft, what are these called? Pastels.
Pastels. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's all right. My brain is not fully functioning. I woke up this morning and was like, was that the alarm? Because I think it was wrong. Tell it to go away.
It's not good when you don't have your sleep properly.
I know. And I slept really good, so kind of disappointing. Okay, here we go. Also, I would like to zoom in a little bit for you guys. Let me see. Can I do it on here? Just going to open that up. Boy, there's a whole lot of getting ready instead of doing. All right, let's see.
It's a lot of tech to deal with when you're trying to art.
Yeah, I know. Let's try this. What do you think?
You're doing more to the there. Whoop. Right a
all
little
right,
bit.
There we go. That is completely on the edge. There's just tape right there. This is
okay.
Tape. So it's completely on the edge of our painting, side and bottom, right there. Okay. All right. So we're going to start with this rock right here. I'm going to go around the rock edges in the back side, because this is what our shadow is being placed.
Yeah. Nikki said she's off this morning. She woke up at 4:30 for no reason at all, and she made herself wait until 5 to get coffee.
I don't like when your brain does that to you. That's not fair. Like, I already have enough trouble as it is with my daily routine. I don't need to also lose what little sleep I've got. The precious little sleep I'm allowed.
Yeah. Watercolors with Michael has joined us. He says, PanPastel, yay, this is looking great.
Thank you. Your check is also in the mail, Michael. I'm going to owe you guys a lot of money soon.
And Jane's saying, that's great. Can see the details perfectly.
Oh, good. Good.
Yeah.
Okay, so there is our rock formation. A little bit more definition. Here's the problem, though. I just put the entire painting over the top of my pencil. So bear with me. I'm going to pull this stuff out for you. There we go.
And Melissa's is an early bird as well. She got up at 6:30.
All right. Well, we should all have some sort of like a hotline where we can message each other if, hey, I'm struggling. Anybody else awake at this ridiculous hour?
It's called Discord.
That's true. That's true. She's got a point, you guys.
That's true, Nikki. Nikki says maybe we were all just excited for today's show.
Oh, you're really good. Really earning your points. That's crazy. Hogwash is what that is, but I'll take it. I'll take it.
Well, you never know. Could it be?
Yeah. So I've been uploading these videos to YouTube for this particular painting. I have to wait 24 hours before I'm allowed to put it up on YouTube. That's my deal with Twitch. And I put them up, but I don't know that anybody is appreciating that they're there. I've lost a few subscribers because of it, I think. So I don't know if I'm going to do that with all of them, but I had a little conversation with Linz, who said it would be nice if she could see them because she can't watch the Twitch just now.
Right.
But it would be nice if she would be able to see them. And so I said, well, do you think I should put them on to the YouTube? She's like, if it's easy, yeah. And it's so easy. I mean, I just click a button and then it goes over to YouTube almost automatically for me.
Yeah.
I don't have to download. I don't have to worry about internet speeds. I don't have to do any of that stuff. So I thought it would be a real simple way for folks who, you know, many folks are not able to watch on Twitch or don't want to. And it's totally understandable.
Yeah.
And I would never want anybody to feel uncomfortable or, you know, because there are some things you can run into over here that I would hate to put somebody in that position where they feel uncomfortable or any of that kind of stuff.
Yeah. So That's a good idea. Yeah. I did notice you'd uploaded it.
Yeah. And that's the other thing is that I don't know that it has, I don't know that it's notifying.
I got a notification.
You did? Okay.
All right. The notifications are getting better on YouTube. The only thing is when you go live, the notifications don't work until after it's rendered, after the live, and then it's rendered, and then you can watch
again.
Yeah,
that's goofy. Yeah.
It's strange for a live platform not to inform you that somebody's live.
Yeah, that's goofy. And there's something about that. I'm not sure why that is, but it was something about the way that I went live or something. Weird. I don't know. It's all so weird.
It happens with Vicky Ross all the time.
And does it?
And watercolors with Michael as well.
Really?
Yeah.
You know what has helped me with them? Well, with him anyway. Because he's a member of the Discord of the Crafters community, I get notified in Discord every time.
Yeah, I noticed that. Yeah. Discord's good with notifications.
Yeah. I mean, if you have them on, you'll know what's going on in ours, at least for sure. Okay, I got to use my stick again.
Nikki says she didn't get a notification. She's getting very few with a lot of channels she's followed.
Yeah. Hmm. I am too. I don't, and you're talking about YouTube, I'm sure.
Yeah.
I am too. I'm not getting the same reaction to, like, when Michael goes live, I don't get those from YouTube almost at all.
They show up in me notifications after his live. And it's been rendered, so I don't know.
So strange.
I'll check my set and see where I've got them on. Actually, I can do that now. Whilst we're on. Oh, sorry.
What'd you do?
I don't know if you heard that.
Nope, didn't hear anything.
No, I wasn't screen sharing. That's good. I accidentally pressed play on YouTube then.
Yep, nope, didn't affect us at all. That was just in your headset, probably. I like this. Michael says, that's weird. Should I just text you? Hey, maybe you should. Let me know.
Discord's very good at letting you know.
Yeah, I've had no problem with that part of it. And I think my biggest dilemma is having the time when you actually are live. That's my biggest dilemma.
Yeah.
That I have the time to be able to go and do it, but I'll pop in. You might not see me there, but I pop in and check out what you're up to. I should probably leave a message every time, but I hate to leave. After I've left a message, then I hate to leave. Like, I don't want them. Like, it was funny. I was watching Patty Tully Parrish the other night.
Yeah.
The other day, whatever. I had a few minutes and I was sitting there and she went live and I went, oh, I'm going to pop over there. And then I had to go and it was like, oh, hang on. Oh, yeah. Okay. Well, let me just say, you say goodbye. And then I hear her talking again as I'm clicking it off. I'm like, okay, just pretend that wasn't to me. I know she was asking a question too. So it was like, I don't know. I don't have the answer. I have to go.
Oh, dear.
Too funny. All right, we're going to pop in some highlights on some of these because they're just not standing out the way I want. But I love the little bits of detail that we're getting in this stuff. Like, you don't know exactly what that is, but it's clearly rocks or something, right?
Right.
And I think I'm going to move this just a little bit over so you can see me add detail to the rocks here.
Andrew says he just puts the regulars on his calendar and lets it remind him.
Yeah, Andrew's really good at that.
Yeah.
For sure.
I can't find where my subscriptions are to on YouTube to find how I've got my settings. Because since they closed Google Plus down, the notifications on YouTube have been working for me.
Oh, no, that's too funny.
Just finding things on YouTube now.
Mm-hmm. Let's put in a bit of black underneath this. I like that.
Right, I think I'm on the dashboard now. Oh, it's a nightmare to get to. I've got 12 subscribers on YouTube and I haven't got one video.
Just in case you ever do, that's what they're there for. They are really hoping that one day you will post a video. I may be even one of them.
Nope.
Well, you won't see it because I have mine hidden.
All right.
Yeah.
These are people I've looked at. Subscribe for a little while and then unsubscribe. They must automatically subscribe to people who subscribe to them.
Maybe.
No, I don't know how to get to that now, so.
Homework.
It says, what's new? Updates on channel verification. We've heard you loud and clear and are making updates to our channel verification program. Learn more.
There you go. Whatever that means. This right here looks like a rock bed to me, like they're down in a crevice.
Yeah. Oh, I'm missing comments. Nikki's saying, we found out the internet problem. CenturyLink was disrupted over here with a new development being built. So if I disappear again, it's our internet. Should be fixed today, hopefully.
Well, at least you found out what your problem was. We still have no idea what our problem is. It has nothing to do with a new development because this is old land over here. We don't have that same growth spurt you're having over in your area. But, man, it's really been a pain in the neck because our internet about midday crashes probably 5-6 times.
Wow.
Oh, it's been so frustrating. I was on working with Michael. I think it was on Sunday or Saturday. I don't remember which day it was. And I eventually had to use my hotspot just to have a conversation with him because it was cutting out so bad. It was awful. All right. I really need to work on this middle section here. So we're going to move this backwards because, see, now we've got all that detail, and look at how plain that looks.
Yeah.
Really need to work on this section here, too.
Melissa's saying, any ideas for YouTube? Do you mean for uploading videos or videos to watch, Melissa?
All right, I think I want to add some rocks. That rock bed needs to come out and around and go up to here, this one. So yeah. We're going to add that.
Would make sense.
I think so.
Nikki says, that's because we're in the country, Heather. It's the cows, LOL.
Yeah, it's the cows. That's their fault.
I know a lot of YouTubers I watch from America do have trouble with their internet frequently.
And which is kind of shocking, isn't it?
Yeah, they're all on different providers as well.
We have a lot of different providers for internet, even just within this valley where we are.
Yeah.
We have a few options.
Does your internet come from a satellite in the sky?
Oh, I don't think so. It's in the ground. Ours comes
is in the ground. Yeah. Ours is in the ground.
Ours at this house actually come through the phone lines, which is so old.
That's how mine comes, with fiber optics.
Yeah, we do not have fiber optic. I wish we could say that, but ours, in Montana, it was through the cable line, like coax cable.
Yeah. Was that any better?
It was much better than what I've been experiencing here, yeah.
Yeah.
And we had much faster upload and download speeds than I get to experience at this house.
Yeah.
The guy came out when we upgraded our stuff. The guy came out and he said, well, it looks like somebody painted over your phone line here. I'm like, what? I mean, that we didn't do that, obviously. That was done when somebody worked on the house. But
yeah,
I'm like, what? And he goes, yeah, paint will interfere with your internet speeds for sure. I'm like, you think? Okay. Thanks for that bit of info there, buddy. Thank you.
That's crazy.
Yeah, it was a little weird.
It was like the operator saying, because my phone line socket is next to a radiator, the radiator's interfering with it.
Oh, okay.
So I said, just pass me to an engineer. you don't know what you're talking about. Well, it's ridiculous. Melissa says,
grasp my own straws, thank you.
Melissa says, videos to upload.
Oh,
that's personal to you, Melissa.
Yeah, you have to do what you like to do. It doesn't matter what other people want.
Yeah, if you just record yourself and enjoy how it's gone, just upload it.
Yeah.
People will find you, and if they like you, they'll keep following and watch more videos, hopefully. Nikki says, got to miss the good old dial-up with the phone line.
Oh, I
don't know what that was like. I never used it. Was it bad?
Oh, it was awful. AOL was hilarious because it made this horrible sound, this dial-up sound, when you got started.
Oh, wow.
So you would turn on your computer, wait like 10 minutes for it to get to the point where you could use it. So this is how my routine would go. I would turn on the computer and then go make coffee. Then once the coffee was done, I would come back to the computer and turn on the internet. And then I would go make the kids breakfast. And while it was dialing up and everything else that it was doing, I was making breakfast, getting the kids all ready for whatever. At that time, they were just babies.
Yeah.
I think I only had the two kids at the time. And one of them had to go to school. So I would make his lunch and clean up the dishes and then get him ready for school. And then I would go, oh, yeah, I wanted to look up something on the internet. And I'd come back to the internet and I would search for 3-4 hours trying to find something. Because back then, if you didn't put the www dot,
yeah,
and all the other stuff, the details that you needed in order to get through to whatever it was that so-and-so said they had a website that would answer all these questions. Oh my gosh. It was like, forget it. I'm just going to play solitaire.
Yeah, it sounds like a nightmare. Nikki's saying it was horrible.
It was horrible. And then it was like, why would you ever go on the internet? There's no reason to go on the internet. I don't know why anybody would ever do that. No reason.
Sorry, Michael. Michael sent some bits and he's saying, I guess they didn't show up today.
Yeah, Michael, you missed our conversation at the beginning. My wine glass is missing. Everything's missing. 911 called to Michael to help with this because we don't know what's going on. And I went back in, recopied the link, put it back into the thing, and it's still not working. So I don't know if Streamlabs is broken or what the dealio is, but 'tis not good. I know that much. Oh, I'm off camera. Okay, let's zoom out so we can get an overall feel for this picture. Wow, that went far.
That's looking fabulous.
I like the details that we put in. This is looking like I want it to look now. Now it looks like a rocky bed, sort of like a dried mm-hmm. bed of river once ran through this area. You can see the shadows. You can see the shadows. We see some detail here. I think I want to detail this cactus.
Yeah.
I'm going to put a little bit more depth into this one right here, this one in the back.
It's definitely pulled the cactus in the bed forward and the mountain further back now.
Good. Yeah, because for a while there, it felt like this was all right up here in your face, and now it does definitely feel much further pressed back.
It does. Yeah, Jane's agreeing. Internet was so frustrating and useless in the beginning.
I just remember I had met my birth mom for the first time. And I hadn't met her yet. We were just talking. And she said, well, I am on the internet. And I was like, you are? Like, that just seems so weird. Yeah, I have a, we have a website. You can go see my, what was it? She was a fly fishing instructor at the time.
All right.
You can go see where we book our, whatever they're called when you go, like you need a guide.
Yeah.
I'm like, okay, well, I'll check it out. And she gave me part of the address, but not the whole thing. And I'm typing it every way I can possibly type it. And I never could find her. Eventually, when I went and met her in person, she showed me on her thing. This is it. And I realized I wasn't typing in the, you know, the whole address or whatever. Boy, those were the days when you had to do that.
Michael says this is the word excursion.
Maybe.
To bake the fishing.
Maybe, yeah.
Melissa like says,
I don't even know. But, okay, Melissa said.
It looks like the Rocky Mountains.
Yeah, close. It's the superstition.
I love the name of it. Superstition. They must be doing something in StreamYard because my comments keep going and then they're coming back. And
we should probably tell Gage about that because they probably want to know that you're having trouble with that.
Yeah, I don't know how bad the internet was back in the day because I didn't come online till 2008.
Oh my gosh, yeah. I mean, we're talking about mid to late 90s is when when we got it at home. We had it at work, but when we finally broke down and bought a PC, because prior to that we had work had given we had Apples.
Yeah.
Before they called Max. We had Apple computers at home. And actually, I think we even called them Macintosh. You know, no.
Yeah.
Life has just gotten way too busy. Now we can't call it a Macintosh. That's too many syllables. So we now say things like Max.
I had a home computer. The kids went on it, but 9 times out of 10, they were playing from a disc rather than online.
Exactly. Oh, my gosh. We had Oregon Trail. We had the Oregon Trail game. The kids played that all the time. And then they'd go to work or go to school, I mean, and then I would play because finally I get some time on the computer. I always died, though. I never last very long. And it was always due to not eating food. Like, I don't understand that. That how could I die not eating food? Come on.
I got into the Facebook games the farming games when I first went on.
Oh, you know what's funny about that? When I did homeschool the boys later on after we had all three of them moved to Montana and everything, and I was homeschooling, and they all wanted to play these games that they saw. And so I made them a part of the school. So when I made them, like, you would have to figure out the most economical way to spend your money to get the most yield of crop and stuff. And then you had daily chores that you had to get on and do all of your work. Otherwise your crops would die.
Yeah.
I'm like, if they're going to do it, then I'm going to make it so that they
they're learning, yeah.
That it has some sort of learning thing. But
it sounds like you've had a lot of good ideas homeschooling.
Yeah, why did we do things when we could? I mean, there were some things where we had a lot of tragedy too when the kids were in those early years.
Yeah.
So there were some issues that we had to deal with, lots of heart issues, but
you've got through them as a family.
Yeah, and they seem to be doing okay. nobody's lost their abilities to breathe or anything, which is, I count a plus. I count that as a mega plus, because
definitely
there were many days where I didn't think anyone would be breathing at the end of it. So
yeah,
it's a win.
It's a tough life. Oh, I zoned out for a good couple of years playing the farm town mainly. I've got a paraplegic friend down Derbyshire, and I used to do it with me not sleeping. I used to do a lot for her during the night as well.
Yeah.
I think that's
I have a friend who did a lot of work for folks. Like, it was like a service she was providing. She never got paid for it or anything, but it was how she passed her time because she had sleepless nights too.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
Yeah, I would log into her account and do it that way.
Yeah.
But then I started getting hand and elbow problems off using the mouse.
Yeah. I bet.
Still to this day, I have problems because of all the intense farming that I did with my mouse.
Intense farming. I wonder if you could apply for some sort of,
government grant.
Yeah. That's too funny. This is serious. I've been farming for years.
Mum used to say, "You do nothing all day." I says, "Do you know what I do on my farm?" She used to just shake her head and roll her eyes.
What is so funny about that is Michael and I were just talking yesterday, I think it was yesterday, about how we were remembering folks that we used to connect with or whatever from Google Plus days, and how you don't see them anymore because Google Plus is gone and whatnot. And it's just so funny to think of, like, going back even further to how the internet used to be or whatever.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think that's all so funny. So funny. Okay. Now that I've added all this detail here, I feel like I need to continue that over here.
Yeah.
So just it's like looking, putting in the shadows.
It's looking absolutely fabulous. I think I came online around about the right time, 2008, because I've never had a problem with internet or anything.
Well, Andrew's been around since before the internet was even created. I think he was around before there was even computers.
I was never interested.
Well, that's how most of my family is right now. The only computer that they really comprehend and understand, any computer knowledge, is all Facebook. Like, they do not think of websites or apps or, you know, none of that stuff even really connects to them whatsoever. So when I say things like, you know, I've built a new website and I'd love for you to come check it out, or they asking how you can buy something, you know, how can I buy some of your work? And, well, you can go to our website. And the response is almost always, what? So you have a website? Like, what does that even mean?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a big learning curve when you first go online. I mean, I met a lot of my now Facebook friends, even though I haven't been on for months, on a crossword puzzle website.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's the main reason I went online, is because it was costing me a fortune in crossword books, and they were getting too easy. So I found a website, I can't remember what it's called now, but they had a message board where people could chat.
Oh, message boards. Wow, I forgot about those too.
Yeah, and it was the people on there who convinced me to join Facebook. And that's when I got into the farming games.
Okay, you guys. I think it's done.
Well, I think you've done right, so here's, blooming here's marvelous.
Well, we're going to see when we do the big reveal. Actually, let's spray it first before, because it's much easier to spray it when it's taped down. It won't curl back up on me. So we'll spray it first. This is Pastel Fixative SpectraFix. It's my favorite fixative for two reasons. One, it works great. Okay, I forgot that I have to lift it up. It works great. And then, I mean, it's been around since the master's time. This is what they used. So yeah. Why not? And then also because I can use it indoors. So I don't have to go outside in the heat where it's dusty and gross and do anything out there. So now you might be able to see, I'm going to point to it with my stick. You might be able to see some spots. You see those spots?
Yeah.
Okay. Those will evaporate and disappear. Don't freak out. And it does kind of change the color while it's wet, but it'll dry and then it'll be exactly how it was. So,
right.
I've heard a lot of questions about, but it makes my, you know, makes all the colors darker, but I don't experience that.
Yeah.
Once it's dry. Let me take a picture of it at this stage.
Yes. I'd love to know how the old masters discovered the ingredient that goes in the SpectraFix. Because it's from...
Oh, the casein?
Yeah, it's from cows, isn't it?
Yeah, milk casein formula. Yeah. Yeah, so it tells you right here, casein, denatured grain alcohol, water, not for use by children. Those are the ingredients.
Yeah.
I don't know why not for use by children is an ingredient, but whatever. And also, I think I've had this probably 5 years now, 4 years now. And I still have more than half a bottle.
It's expensive for it lasts. Yeah.
Yeah, I use it for watercolors too. I use it for anything that I want to preserve that will not go under glass or if I wanted to add a layer and I'm not getting any marks, no marks are coming, I want to add a layer. I'll use it for that.
Yeah.
Et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So I'm just waiting for it to dry so that we can, as a matter of fact, let's go ahead and use our tool.
I never thought to use it for watercolors.
Yeah, you can. But, I mean, I don't use it regularly. It's not something I normally do.
Yeah.
But it's there if I need to. So what are we getting? Conversation. I'm blowing on it. So thank you, Jane. Thank you. It's not working very well. But Jane says she was definitely around before. That's hilarious.
Yeah.
That's hilarious. Leonardo turned down doing an endorsement because SpectraFix wouldn't pay him enough. Now that's funny. That is funny. All right. It's still a little bit wet in the sense of the paper is wet, but the top of it isn't. So and I know that the paper is wet because there is some buckling. Can you see it if I do this? Can you see the buckling? Let's see.
Not really.
There's buckling. Yeah, it's just not picking it up, but it's like this a little bit.
Yeah.
That's why it's easier to do it when it's taped down, and I should probably not take this tape off just yet, but I'm anxious and without patience. So
try and hold back a little bit longer. Just I don't want it ripping.
All right, but who's going to talk to me? Who's going
to
say anything?
I'll talk to you.
Just gotta make some.
We can carry on talking. We've done quite well today with chatting.
We have. I'm proud of us. All right, fine.
Jane's fanning with a hand now to help. Let's all sit and wave at the screen. I'm imagining everybody and the families looking at them like they've gone crazy.
Here we go. This is the only thing this coupon is good for.
I've got paints to order today as well.
Oh, do you?
Yeah.
Which paints are you ordering?
A couple more, M. Graham.
Oh, any colors that I need to know about?
Well, the Queen Violet that you suggested.
That's a favorite.
And the turquoise.
Yeah, I can't get away from turquoise either. Turquoise is it the same one that I've got? Is that the one you're going to get?
I don't know. I haven't picked it yet.
No. I'm thinking of the teal that came in the summer pack. That teal that came in the summer pack is so opaque.
Yeah.
It's a strange paint compared to every other paint in my set. Because it's very, very opaque.
It is. Is the turquoise more transparent?
I think so. And I don't know if I have that one, do I?
I'm sure you've mentioned it.
Oh, look at that crisp edge.
Because I found an online shop called Jackson's.
Because
I can't, for some reason, I can't get the Queen Violet on Amazon. Look at that clean edge.
Look at that edge, it's so crisp. Yeah. I love it.
I love watching this happen.
I know, this is somehow satisfying, isn't it?
It is.
Unless it rips, then it's not.
No. But you've got it doubled over on itself, which helps a lot for it not to rip.
Yeah, this is the trick. I know I get a lot of people tell me, just use a heat tool, just do, you know, all these things. It's like, I know why it rips when it rips. I know exactly why it rips. And a heat tool would not have changed that.
No, that's how you pull the tape off.
And I also know not to go too fast.
Yeah.
And when I put the tape down, I do the stick off, you know.
Yeah, you do, yeah. That's one thing I always forget to do, take some of the sticky off. I rarely use tape these days, so.
Oh my gosh.
Looking marvelous.
I love this.
Holding my breath.
I know. To get down to the last 3 inches and have it rip then would be really sad news.
Oh, it would.
But we made it.
Yay!
There we go. That's gorgeous. All right, watch this. We're going to make it even more beautiful-er.
I love it. So much depth.
I actually got this out last night so that way I would be able to show it to you.
Oh, the frame, yeah. Oh, wow. Oh, wow, look at that. You got it on Instagram, Heather. That is stunning.
There it is.
Absolutely stunning.
Da, 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 da.
You're so clever.
That's pretty cool. I think we did really good. You guys are great for being here for this.
Absolutely love it.
Of course, I can't get a very good picture of it because I have a camera and a light in the way. Figures.
Well, when you can get a good picture, you'll upload it, I imagine.
There's the camera and there's the light.
Yeah.
Oh, that's funny stuff. All right. I think I'm going to send the picture just like that. Why not?
Why not?
The behind the scenes that only you guys will understand because you were here for it live.
Yeah. See, there is perks to being with you when you're live.
Well, I would hope so. At least one perk, if anything.
Jane saying it's beautiful. And I agree.
All right, there it is. Oh, I just saw Michael's latest picture. Look at that.
Oh, wow, yeah.
Oh, my gosh, you guys, go check out Watercolors with Michael on Instagram. That's a beautiful painting.
Michael, Morro
Rock,
gorgeous.
Morro Bay, California. Oh, wow. My gosh, you just added that 9 minutes ago. Look at you multitasking. That's gorgeous. Wow. All right, not to be distracted during a live show or anything. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that's it for today. And I think even that's it for this week as far as this painting's concerned, because tomorrow we're going to start a whole new project.
Oh, wow.
You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to ask over on Discord what we should be working on. So I want to see you guys over on Discord. If you're a member of the crafters community, it is free. I want you to come over and answer the question over on Discord. I'm going to be posting it here shortly what we should do next. I might even have some samples, like some ideas, some like, would you like to see me paint this and how type of thing, you know?
I'll put the link in the chat.
That would be great. All right, you guys, that's it. That's it. I think that's, oh, I forgot to sign it. What? How could you forget?
Oh, what have I done now?
How could you forget to sign it, Heather? Where am I going to sign it? Can I use my white pencil, do you think?
Why not?
Well, it's not very sharp. I need to sharpen this pencil. But where is the pencil sharpener? Here it is. Okay, so let's sharpen the pencil. This is my favorite pencil sharpener, in case anyone was wondering.
Which one is that one?
The Prismacolor handheld pencil sharpener. But I've not tried to sharpen pastel sticks yet, or pastel pencils yet. So I don't know how that will work. But I'm going to put it right here. Oh, that's not very visible, although I wasn't pushing very hard either.
It'll still be damp, so you'll have to be careful.
No, it's pretty dry.
Oh, good.
So, that's it. We're done.
The picture on Instagram looks stunning, too. Absolutely love
Thank
it.
You. All right, you guys, that's it. We're done. We're done here. Thank you for joining again. And thank you for your comments and stuff, because that really matters. If you are watching this replay and you made it all the way to the end, first of all, I want to say you deserve some sort of a reward. You should probably leave a comment letting me know, because I will have a reward for you. And for those of you who join us on our lives here on Twitch, and especially our subscribers, I really appreciate you guys. And by subscribers, I mean anyone who donates to the Kraaft Shaak. You guys are all subscribers to me. And when you make a donation, you become a VIP or a moderator on our Twitch channel. That's the way we're going to do it. So real soon, you're going to see your moderation or VIP status disappear if you are not a donor. So that's how we're going to do it. We're going to do donors on any platform, become VIPs over here, and then if you are a subscriber, obviously you get subscriber status, which as you can see on Jane's name there, she has the little Kraaft Shaak logo next to her name. That's because she's a subscriber. So
she does.
All right, you guys, that's it. Let's head out.
Take care, everyone.
All righty. Bye-bye, guys.